why I feel I'd be a good top 40 material or candidate. The main reason is that I believe in doing everything that I do well and being focused in terms of the things that I'm doing. I know sometimes you tend to focus on a candidate who does just one thing, but with me, I'm multifaceted. I practice as an architect and urban planner. I am a founding director and also run Little Einsteins East Africa. And additionally, I am privileged to represent my colleagues, being the president of the Architectural Association of Kenya. So I'm able to wear these different hats, and I think as a woman, that is a thing that I'm proud of, to be able to wear these different hats and to wear them well. I think my biggest drive is the focus of doing hard work and seeing the benefits of hard work. Fundamentally, I come from a family that is very hardworking in nature. We believe that there's absolutely no substitute for hard work. And for me, that is my daily drive. I have seen it in my parents, I see it in my siblings, and I hope to impact my children also to be hardworking. So that is my daily drive. Architecture and is typically still a very male-dominated field. I remember when I sat my examination back in 2008, we were a class of about 50 students, and five of us were female. Today, at least the numbers are a little bit closer to almost being 50-50. But throughout my career, of course, I've always been challenged in that I'll go to a site and everybody from the fundi to the project manager is male, except for myself. And architects tend to take the lead in site meetings. So you would have to be very settled in who you are, being the only woman on a site, and just be confident, competent in what you know. So for me, the challenge has been that of always being the only woman on site or next to the only woman on the site. Additionally, as current president of the Architectural Association of Kenya, the membership actually is 85% male. I'll just let that sink in, 85% male. It's an elected position, and I was elected by the membership, which for me says our membership is so progressive. So yes, those are challenges, but I always see them as one more thing to break past. So definitely my passion, besides practicing as an architect, urban planner, and of course the AK leadership, I'm very passionate about STEM education, and that's science, technology, engineering, and mathematics. And that's why I founded Little Einsteins East Africa back in 2016. The company is a STEM edutainment company. We focus on teaching children STEM learning through hands-on learning, that is project-based learning. And how we do it is we give them an experiment and take them through from the initial introduction right until conclusion and allow children to learn by doing. Our focus for children is kids aged 3 to 12 years. It's amazing to watch children at 3 years old being so curious in terms of science, tech, and engineering and math. And what you'd realize if you teach the concepts at that very early age is that they remain with them throughout the rest of their lives. By the time these subjects are being introduced to them more theoretically, they have caught on. So for me, that was really something passionate for me, because I grew up in the traditional 844 system, and by the time I was introduced to the sciences, I did not enjoy it. I had an interview once where I was asked what I would tell my younger self. Like if I was to look back to myself 15 years ago, what I would tell her. And one of the things I would definitely tell her is not to take things so seriously, life or death. Every hurdle that comes has a reason and it has a season. And it will come, you will handle it, and it will pass. So for me, I think that is fundamentally my biggest lesson, is that there's nothing really insurmountable in this world. Challenges will come and they're part of life. Even as I sit here, I know I have not faced the challenges that I've not come to the end of my challenges, but they will come and they will go. And just again, there is no substitute for hard work. Believe in what you're doing, be ethical, enjoy what you do, be passionate about what you do, and tackle every single challenge as it comes.